Let's now look at the experimental results. We will start with the best case numbers. To gather the best case numbers, they used a synthetic load in which they vary the number of requests that are issued against the web server, and every single one of the requests is for the exact same file. Like, for instance, every single one of the requests is trying to get index.html. This is the best case because really in reality, clients will likely be asking for different files. And in this pathological best case, it's likely basically the file will be in cache, so every one of these requests will be serviced as fast as possible. There definitely won't be any need for any kind of disk I/O. So for the best case experiments, they measure bandwidth, and they do that. They vary the file size of 0 to 200 kilobytes, and they measure bandwidth as the n, the number of requests, times the file size over the time that it takes to process the n number of requests for this file. By varying the file size, they vary the work that both the web server performs on each request, but also the amount of bytes that are generated on a request. So we sort of assume that as we increase the file size, that the bandwidth will start increasing. So let's look at the results now. The results show the curves for every one of the cases that they compare. The flash results are the green bar. SPED is the single process event-driven model. MT multi-threaded, MP multi-process. Apache, this bottom curve corresponds to the Apache implementation. And Zeus, that corresponds to the darker blue. This is the SPED model that has two instances of SPED, so the dual process event-driven model. We can make the following observations. First, for all of the curves, initially when the file size is small, bandwidth is slow. And as the file size increases, the bandwidth increases. We see that all of the implementations have very similar results. SPED is really the best. That's the single process event driven. And that's expected because it doesn't have any threads or processes among which it needs to context switch. Flash is similar, but it performs that extra check for the memory presence. In this case, because this is the single file trace, so every single one of the requests is for the single file, there's no need for blocking I/O, so none of the helper processes will be invoked, but nonetheless, this check is performed, so that's why we see a little bit lower performance for Flash. Zeus has an anomaly. Its performance drops here a little bit, and that has to do with some misalignment for some of the DMA operations. So not all of the optimizations are bug-proof in the Zeus implementation. For the multi-threaded and the multi-process models, the performance is lower because of the context switching and extra synchronization. And the performance of Apache is the worst because it doesn't have any optimizations that the others implement. Now, since real clients don't behave like the synthetic workload, we need to look at what happens with some of the realistic traces, the AllNet and the CS trace. Let's take a look at the AllNet trace first. First, we see that for the AllNet trace, the performance is very similar to the best case, with SPED and Flash being the best, and then multi-threaded, multi-process, and Apache dropping down. Note that we're not including the Zeus performance. The reason for this trend is because the AllNet trace is the small trace, so most of it will fit in the cache and will have a similar behavior like what we had in the best case, where all the requests are serviced from the cache. Sometimes, however, blocking I/O is required. It mostly fits in the cache. Given this, given the blocking I/O possibility, SPED will occasionally block, whereas in Flash, the helper processes will resolve the problem. And that's why we see here that the performance of Flash is slightly higher than the performance of the SPED. Now, if we take a look at what's happening with the CS trace, this, remember, is a larger trace. So it will mostly require I/O. It's not going to fit in the cache in memory in the system. Since the system does not support asynchronous I/O operations, the performance of SPED will drop significantly. So relative to where it was, close to Flash, now it's significantly below Flash, and in fact, it's below the multiprocess and the multithreaded implementations. Considering the multi-threaded and the multi-process, we see that the multi-threaded is better than the multi-process. And the main reason for that is that the multi-threaded implementation has a smaller memory footprint. The smaller memory footprint means that there will be more memory available to cache files. In turn, that will lead to less I/O, so this is a better implementation. In addition, the synchronization and coordination and context switching between threads in a multi-threaded implementation is cheaper. It happens faster than among processes in a multi-process implementation. In all cases, Flash performs best. Again, it has the smaller memory footprint compared to the multi-threaded and the multi-process, and that results in more memory available for caching files or caching headers. As a result of that, fewer requests will lead to a blocking I/O operation, which further speeds things up. And finally, given that everything happens in the same address space, there isn't a need for explicit synchronization like with the multi-threaded or multi-process model. And this is what makes Flash perform best in this case. In both of those cases, Apache performed worse. So let's try to understand if there's really an impact of the optimizations performed in Flash. And here the results represent the different optimizations, the performance that's gathered with Flash without any optimizations, that's the bottom line, then Flash with the path-only optimization, so the path-only, that's the directory lookup caching, so that's like the computation caching part. Then the red line here, the path and mmap, so this includes caching of the directory lookup plus caching of the file. And then the final bar, so the final line, the black line, that includes all of the optimizations. So this is the directory lookup, the file caching, as well as the header computations of the file. And we see that as we add some of the optimizations, this impacts the connection rate. So the performance that can be achieved by the web server significantly improves. We're able to sustain a higher connection rate as we add these optimizations. This tells us two things. First, that these optimizations are indeed very important. And second, they tell us that the performance of Apache would have been also impacted if it had integrated some of the same optimizations as the other implementations.